Todoist recently added a number of extensions which, as the name implies, extends the functionality of Todoist. Now we're going to take a look at some of these in some upcoming videos for the Academy, but I wanted to kick off by looking at the Habit Tracker. Now building good habits is key to personal growth, and Todoist now recognises this, so let's get it installed. I'm in the web version of Todoist now, and these extensions only work with the web and desktop versions. They're not going to work on your mobile devices. So I'll come up to my avatar here, then down to integrations. And then once in integrations, I'll click on browse. And there are lots of goodies here to get your teeth into. And of course, we want extensions. Now, these are the 6 extensions that have been added. I've not tested all of them yet. I will do, though. And if I think there are any worth doing a video on, I'm going to do so. The Habit Tracker definitely is. So I'll click. We've got an overview here and some key features. And if you want to learn more about it, then click this link. I've just opened it in another tab, and this is just a slightly more detailed overview on what the Habit Tracker extension does. Now, we don't need this though, because I'm going to show you how it works. So I'll close it, and then here I'll click Add, then Confirm. Now, the first time you come in here, you're going to be prompted to authenticate your Todoist account. Now, I've already done that in order to be able to check the extension works correctly before recording, so I don't need to do it. But we can see it's already authenticated here. And at the bottom, we have 2 checkboxes. Now, if you want the tasks that you're going to track to be assigned labels, then ensure the top box is checked. If you want to go with the default labels, then keep the second box checked. Alternatively, you can uncheck it, then click on the dropdown to choose your own custom label. Now, I'm going to keep these ones, though, and then click on the cross to come out of here. Now let's find a task that we want to track. So down here in health and fitness, this daily run for 30 minutes, I want this to be a tracked habit. So I'll go into the task, click on the ellipses, and down here we now have an option to track habits. So I'll select it. Now there is a note of caution here. It tells you that the description for the task is going to be overwritten because it's going to display the current streak for the habit. That's fine. I'll click track task. And the habit is set up. So what's new on the screen here? Well, the description field now has the current streak, hence the warning before. There is also a comment that has just been added to the task, indicating the task is now being tracked. I'm going to complete the task here, and the streak has now gone up by 1. And down here in the comments, it's been edited to add in the instance. So when the habit is fully built, I'm going to see all of the dates where it's been completed. There is also a label, streak, that's been added. Okay, let's do another one. I'm going to close this. Come across to my family. And there is a task to eat with the family. Now, I'm not going to go into the task. Instead, I can just click these ellipses. Come down to track habit. Click track task. And I can see we have a comment and a new description. So I'll check it as complete. And there's my new label. Let's just do one last one. I'm going to come into growth and development here. I need to watch a daily video, so let's hover at the end once more. Actually, I just need to clear this goal notification because it's hiding the track habit. Then track task. And there, that's done. Let's mark it as complete. And if I go in, we can see the same information as we had for the first task that we did. So Todoist can now be a habit tracker as well. And if you want to see an overview of all of the habits that you're tracking, simply come out, go into filters and labels. Because down here, underneath shared labels, if I expand that, we've got the streaks label, which if I click, shows us a list of all tasks with that streaks label. They've all got a streak currently of 1, but I'm sure they're going to build up in the coming days. Thanks for watching. This was a free video that forms part of the Mike Productive Mac Guide to Todoist. And to enroll for the free 30-minute course or the full version that has over 4 hours worth of content, go to learn.myproductivemac.com or click on the links in the description below. And I hope to see you soon.